إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, there is a hadith that I want to share in which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم prays one of his companions رضي الله عنه about certain qualities that he had. And throughout the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we find many ayat, many hadith, where the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alaihi wasallam reinforces these qualities, encourages us to adopt these qualities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself in various ways encourages us to have these certain qualities. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to Al-Ashaj Abdul Qais, one of his companions radiyallahu anhu, he said, "Inna fika khaslatain yuhibbuhum Allah," that you have about you two things, two character traits, two characteristics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves both of them. Two things about you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Now you can imagine what it must feel like for a person to be approached by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then he approaches him. It's not the other way around. Usually people ask the Prophet ﷺ a question, or they come to him with a concern, or they go to him about something, and then he gives them a lesson, he teaches them, and he says something in return. But here the Prophet ﷺ goes to Al-Ashaj, and he says to him, "You have two things about you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really loves." So this shows you how when the Prophet ﷺ is going out of his way, that these two qualities, these two character traits, or something that if we adopt them as well, if we're mindful of them, and if we can incorporate them into our life as much as possible, then inshallah that applies to us as well, that we will get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with His love. But he goes to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he says, "You have two qualities about you that Allah loves." And he says, "Al-hilmu wal-anat." You have hilm. And hilm is something which is like a gentleness. One of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Halim. And it's this quality of being gentle, of being soft, of being kind in a very soft-hearted way. And wal ana, and ana is like a sort of patience. It's to take things slowly, to be able to not react in a rush, and basically the quality of being calm and responding in a manner that is calm. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praises Al-Ashaj, and he says, "You have this gentleness inside of you. You have this calmness to who you are as a person. And these are two qualities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala absolutely loves." And he conveys this to Al-Ashaj. And then he responds, and in another narration, he says to him, "Ya Rasulullah, is this something that I've been able to do on my own? That I've been able to acquire on my own? Or is this something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created me upon? That He made me this way?" And he said, "Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made you this way, and He loves you for the way that He made you." And in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he says, "Al-ilmu bit-ta'allum wal-hilmu bit-tahallum." That knowledge comes from when you go and you seek knowledge, from learning. You want knowledge, you put in the effort, you learn, and you will get knowledge. And he says the same thing about this quality, al-hilm. Al-hilmu bit-tahallum, that this gentleness, this patience, this kindness, you get it when you practice it, when you put it into practice. So we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this sahabi radiyallahu anhu a special favor in giving him, you know, very much an easier time to be able to display these qualities. But we understand by the continuous message of Allah, by the continuous encouraging of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that this is something we're responsible for adorning ourselves with as well. having these qualities of gentleness, kindness, calmness within our life and within all the interactions that we have in our life. So as for the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in many, many different ways. And He talks about the righteous, those who have taqwa. And in many places in the Quran, He gives qualifiers to what are those people that have taqwa. And in one of those, He mentions, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, that those who can suppress their rage and those who can forgive people. And this is one of the qualities where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is defining about, or talking about, the righteous people. Meaning righteous people do get mad, they do get enraged, they can be furious, but what makes them good, what makes them righteous, what makes them closer to Allah, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ, they can suppress. They're able to suppress and not let that anger dictate how they're going to behave with the other person. And right after that, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. A lot of times the thing that enrages us the most are other people. Whether it's family, whether it's friends, whether it's work, whether it's the environment around you. But there's people involved in making you upset. So those that can suppress their rage, not react out of anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And who can let things go. Those people that can forgive. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah says He loves those, excuse me, who go out of their way to do good. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And again, that quality of love is mentioned with him as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِدْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is facing persecution, ridicule, all of this bad treatment early on in the city of Mecca, from the people that he's trying to give guidance to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to him and he says, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, be forgiving. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ, be forgiving and command what is good and turn away from those people that are ignorant. Meaning don't waste your time with them, but adopt this quality of being calm in your reaction. Don't react back to them the way they are reacting to you. Just because they're pushing you to the limits, they're calling you names, they're saying all sorts of things about you, they're lying about you, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were going around and telling other people that this is a madman, this is a sorcerer, there's a whole campaign to ruin his reputation, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the city of Mecca. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, be forgiving, command what is good, keep going forward, وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, and just turn away from those people that are ignorant. And he continues on in his reaction, and his reaction was one of the things that really pushed people towards Islam as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ. Good and evil, they're not equal. Good deeds, evil deeds, good reaction, evil reaction, good things, evil things, they are not equal. اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. You should respond in a way that is better than the way someone is acting towards you. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. It may be that the person between whom you and him or them is some kind of enmity, there's some kind of animosity, that this person can become now a devoted friend. And people can change. And we saw this in the example of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how people went from being opposers and even waging war against him sallallahu alaihi wasallam to being his closest and most allied supporters. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the way you choose to respond, when you respond in a way that is better, in a way that is calm, in a way that is gentle, for the majority of the situations that we face as normal people in our lives, we can bring about a change in many, many other things and how people will react. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself was told to react in this way. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also acknowledges that this is not something that is very easy to do. It's not something that's just very easy, very simple. I'm asking you, just be calm in your reaction, be a little bit more gentle in the way you react, especially when we are facing this onslaught that we face as a community with people talking about Muslims and Islam and all these sorts of things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acknowledges it's not something easy. And just like any other action of Islam, prayer, fasting, hajj, all the things we're supposed to do, they're not necessarily easy. They require some type of effort. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. That they will not achieve it except through patience, and you will not achieve it except unless you've been given a significant portion of goodness, a significant portion of goodness. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with these things, but we understand that it does take effort. And just because it takes effort, it means we're supposed to work towards it, not against it. Meaning we don't just make the excuse that I'm not made this way and I can't respond this way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to be this way. And he says, وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. And whoever is patient and forgiving, indeed, these are the matters that require determination. These are things that require a lot of effort. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he compliments and gives this good news to Al-Ashaj. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is supporting this in many ayat of the Quran. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also gave us his guidance in many of his hadith, encouraging his companions to adopt gentleness, kindness, softness in the dealings that they have with each other in general. And so he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Aisha radiallahu anha narrates, إِنَّ اللَّهَ رَفِيقٌ يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقَ فِي الْأَمْرِ كُلِّهِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kind, is gentle, and He loves gentleness, kindness in every matter. He loves gentleness and kindness in every matter. And she said in a different narration, إِنَّ اللَّهَ رَفِيقٌ يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقِ, indeed Allah is gentle, Allah is kind, and He loves kindness. وَيُعْتِي عَلَى الرِّفْقِ مَا لَا يُعْتِي عَلَى الْعُنْفِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you an outcome when you yourself are kind and gentle that He will not give you when you are harsh. When you yourself are kind and gentle in the way that you get to respond, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you an outcome because of your kindness, your gentleness, your calmness that He will not give you when you are harsh. وَمَا لَا يُعْتِي عَلَى مَا سِوَاهُ, and He will not give that same reaction or that same outcome for any other type of a reaction. And so we learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that when people are harsh towards us, if we can be kind and soft in our reaction to them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place a better outcome than if we react harshly in the first place. And for a lot of us, it's our culture, it's our nature, it's a thing that we've been taught that when somebody says something rude to you, you respond in kind. You say something rude back to them, right? A lot of us experience this when we're going to work and we're driving in one of the worst cities that we have for traffic. When you know somebody cuts you off or does something, or there's some kind of situation that happens, you can respond back in kind, or you can choose to respond back in a kinder way, in a gentle way. Right? When somebody needs to get in front, you can let them in front. When you make a mistake, you can apologize. These are things that we can do to change the normal outcome or of the daily things that we have to go through. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah will give you an outcome when you react calmly and gently that He will not give you when you react with harshness. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنَّ الرِّفْقَ لَا يَكُونُ فِي شَيْءٍ إِلَّا زَانَ وَلَا يُنْزَعُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا شَانَ, that kindness and gentleness is not found in anything except that it makes it beautiful. It makes whatever it is you're dealing with beautiful. It beautifies it. And it is not removed from anything except that it disgraces it. It makes it the opposite of beautiful. It's إِلَّا شَانَ. It makes it ugly. It makes it disgraceful. So when you have the opportunity to react to something that you don't like, and you can do so in a calm and collected way, then that will beautify the outcome that you will receive. But when you remove calmness and kindness from the equation, you're only adding to the problem, you're only adding fuel to the fire, you're only creating more issues for yourself. And so that is the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He also said in the hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we all heard the hadith of the man who entered the masjid and he urinated in one of the corners of the masjid. And we usually stop at the reaction of the Prophet ﷺ when he told him, you know, don't do this, this is a masjid, this is not a place. There's an additional portion to that hadith in the end. When Rasulullah ﷺ tells them, pour water over the area that he did this. Because the Sahaba, they all reacted with anger. When he did this, he urinated into the masjid, then they got up and they went to get him and grab him and take him out. Right? Take him outside, not take him out in slang. Take him outside. Right? And so the Prophet ﷺ comes and he says, stop, let him go, let him finish. Get some water, pour it over the sand, and let me talk to him. And then the Prophet ﷺ talks to him. But then he tells his companions, he says, فَإِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُمْ مُيَسِّرِينَ وَلَمْ تُبْعَثُوا مُعَسِّرِينَ, you are all brought out to be people that create ease. You are not brought out to be people that create hardship. He tells this to his companions after somebody, you know, uses the restroom in the masjid, makes the masjid empty, they have to clean it up. The Prophet ﷺ reminds them, Allah has sent you, created you, brought you here as Muslims to be people that bring ease. Don't create more conflict. Don't create more trouble. You're going to react in a harsh way? He's going to react in a harsh way. And he did. He reacted in a harsh way when the Prophet ﷺ explained to him in a calm and collected way. He made dua for the Prophet ﷺ and he made dua for himself, the Prophet, he said, and nobody else. Because he was mad at everybody else for their reaction. And so that harshness brought out more harshness. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told his companions, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُمْ مُجَسِّرِينَ, you have been sent as people that make ease, make things better, And you're not here to make things more complicated, to create more and more problems. So the way you react has a lot to do with that. وعن أنس رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يسروا ولا تعسروا وبشروا ولا تنفروا. In another hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he clearly tells his companions, he says, make things easy, do not make things difficult. You are here to make things easy, do not make things difficult. وبشروا ولا تنفروا. And you make people happy. Bring them news that will make them happy. Bring them, you know, things that will make them cheerful, but do not drive them away. Do not push people away. And so there's action and there's words. In your actions, you can make things easy, you can make things difficult. The Prophet ﷺ tells us, make things easy. And in your words, you can bring happiness, cheerfulness to people in the calm, collected way you talk to them, or you can create harshness in them by being harsh with them. So he said, بَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا. Bring them things that will make them cheerful. Tell them things that will make them cheerful and happy. And do not push them away. Don't drive them away. And this is something that's so general that the Prophet ﷺ gave that advice in such a general way that it applies to everything. The things we do, the faith that we have, how we preach, how we teach in our own homes, how we behave with our own families. This is what we should adopt. That we should try to create ease, calmness, gentleness, and not try to create difficulty. Don't make things more difficult. SubhanAllah, and a lot of times when we try to communicate with our families, we will get very, very difficult in the way that we're communicating, especially when we let anger get into the equation. When you're angry, you may say something that the other person doesn't understand, you expect them to understand, and then you get more angry because they don't understand, they're getting upset now because they thought they understood you, and this is something we have to work on. When you're calm and collected, you can control your emotions, you can wait at a better time to communicate, you will be able to do it much better. As the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah will give you out of your gentleness and calmness that which He will not give you when you react harshly. So by you yourself calming yourself down and being more rash and more calm and collected in your reactions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself will make accommodations and make outcomes better for you in the first place. And the Prophet ﷺ said, من يحرم الرفق يحرم الخير كله. That whoever is deprived of gentleness is deprived of all types of goodness. Whoever is deprived of gentleness is deprived of all types of goodness. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a beautiful hadith, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِمَنْ يَحْرُمُ عَلَى النَّارِ. Should I not inform you about someone who is going to be haram for the hellfire? Meaning the hellfire will not touch this person. أَوْ بِمَنْ تَحْرُمُ عَلَيْهِ النَّارِ. Or the hellfire will not touch this person. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving us, again, these qualities. And he said, should I not tell you about someone who the hellfire will not touch? Immediately our ears should be open. That's the one thing we want. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us Jannah without ever having to face the blink of an eye into the hellfire. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, shall I not inform you of a person who will be haram for the hellfire? They will not be able to touch. And he said, تَحْرُمُ عَلَى كُلِّ قَرِيبٍ هَيِّنٍ لَيِّنٍ سَهْلٍ. That the hellfire is haram, it's prohibited for every person that is qareeb, hayyin, layyin, and sahl. Qareeb, someone that is near. And the scholars, they interpret this as someone that is accessible. Someone that is available and accessible. And we all have a capacity in which we are available and accessible. As fathers, as mothers, as family members, in our workplaces, in our neighborhoods, whatever it is. But if we can be people that are approachable, people that we can draw people close to us as well, this is one of those people. And then he said, hayyin. And hayyin is someone that is simple, modest, easygoing, soft. Layyin, kind of the same way, someone that is gentle and soft. Kullu qareebin hayyin and layyin and sahl. And sahl means just someone that is very easy, easygoing. And not easygoing in the sense that, you know, you let everything go, but easygoing in the way that you're dealing with people. Soft and gentle in the way you're dealing with people. Accessible in the way that you're dealing with people. And this, subhanAllah, has a lot to do with the other half of our circle of life, where, you know, the first half is about us and Allah and how we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there's a huge emphasis that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself places on how we deal with each other. And for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say the hellfire will be haram on a person who is easy, accessible, soft, gentle, kind, etc., etc., it shows a lot about how much power these qualities actually have. And so when he approaches Al-Ashaj Abdul Qais and he goes to him and he says, you know, you have khaslatain, you have two things about you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, Al-Hilmu wal-Ana, you have this gentleness and this calmness about you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And then he goes on to give us all of these hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals all of these ayat, teaching us how to behave with other people, how to control our emotions, how to be, you know, what kind of a reaction we should adopt in the face of difficulties or things we don't like, or when we have arguments with each other. But if we can choose to be calm and gentle and kind, then by the promise of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we believe 100%, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a much better outcome than He will if you react in a harsh way. And if we can keep this in mind, if we can remind each other of this constantly, if we can catch ourselves when we're responding in anger and calm ourselves down, or wait for a time when we've calmed down before we have a communication, before we talk to our family, before we talk to our friends, neighbors, etc., etc., we will find over and over and over again that this is the kind of reaction that really brings about amazing results. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam walks back into the city of Mecca, after the conquest of Mecca, he did something which is unbelievable, that he would forgive a general amnesty. He would forgive these people that tortured his companions, that killed his companions, that made his life difficult, made him leave his hometown of Mecca. Some of the companions, they had to leave their entire belongings and make that migration without even the clothes on their back. This is what these people put the Prophet and his companions through, radiallahu anhum wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what they put them through. And for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come back and say, the majority of you are safe. And after Ta'if, when he goes to seek protection and try to get some help from people outside of Mecca, because his own people have kicked him out, and then, you know, they put their children to stone the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and kick him out of the city of Ta'if, Allah sends an angel. The angel says, look, we can smash these people right now because of what they did to you, the Messenger of Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does what? He says, no, maybe from amongst their children there will be people that will accept Islam. And then that whole town becomes Muslim. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obviously gave this to the Prophet because he knew what his reaction would be. And I've said this time and time again, the examples we have in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they're of extremes. Meaning many of us will not face situations where, you know, people will gather against us to kick us out of, you know, Roswell or Alpharetta, and they will prevent us from worshipping and this and that. Many of us, inshallah, we ask Allah's protection, will not face these severe types of trials. But we have these examples in Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that in such a severe situation, he can forgive, he can be kind-hearted, he can be calm in his reaction. That lesson is for us in the situations that we face in our families, in our communities, with our neighbors, in our places of work. We all get frustrated, we all get upset, and we all get moments where we can get very, very angry. But how we choose to react can dictate the outcome that comes, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always, always bless. And we ask Allah azza wa jal to forgive and pardon us if we've reacted harshly at any time, but to allow us to understand the value of reacting in a calm and collected way. And this is something, wallahi, we experiment with, we will see the results of. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His blessing. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.